Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap 4 video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, in this video today, we're going to just create a quick Bootstrap 4 page and add a logo to it. I've created a logo here and saved it as a 100 wide and 100 pixels tall PNG file. Let's open up the brackets software. This brackets is a free text editor, and you can download it from a link below this video. I'm using an extension for brackets here. If you go to Extension Manager under File here, and if you're building Bootstrap sites, just type in Bootstrap in this search box here. It'll give you a whole load of available Bootstrap templates. I'm using the Bootstrap Starter template today. All these extensions are free. There's an update for it. I'll update that in a while. But if you don't have it installed, there'll just be a little button there to let you install it. And it'll either install it automatically, or it'll take you to their site where you can download a zip file. And once downloaded, you can just drag that zip file over here to install it. But if you're following along and want to use this, fine, download the bracket software, install it, and then just put Bootstrap in and download the Bootstrap Starter template extension. Once you've done that, you'll find this in your menu items up here. Just click on this. And bingo, we've got a brand new little index.html working Bootstrap page. So I'm going to just save this. I'm going to save it in the same folder as I put my logo in that I've just created. And I'm going to call this index.html. You've always got to give it its file extension when you save it from brackets. And if we go to that folder now, there's our index.html, there's the logo. If I double click on that, it'll open it up in your browser of choice. Just pull this over here, it's on another monitor. There we are, that's what we've got. There's a Bootstrap starter template with a little nav bar up the top there and a little bit of text here. These are great for starting to build your websites on. Now what I want to do today is add a logo up here, where it says Navbar. That's actually their Navbar logo. If we go back to brackets, scroll down a little bit, you'll see that word Navbar there, and it's on the Navbar brand here. So we can change that if you just want to use a text. Control S to save, back to the site, refresh, and that should just change to Bootstrap. That's fine if you just want to use text, but I actually want to add an image in there. Perhaps make this a bit bigger. My image that I've actually got saved is 100 by 100, maybe a little too big. Depends on you, how much you want to actually see your logo. Let's just change the view here so you can actually see what's going on. There's the logo. And it's just called logo PNG. So let's insert that instead of that bit of text there. So instead of this bit of text, we want an image. And to do that, it's very easy. I'm just going to open an image tag, IMG. Then we've got to tell it where the image is. So it's SRC equals. Open some inverted commas. It's already found it because it's in the same folder as our index.html. We don't even need to search for it. It's right there. Quite often when building a Bootstrap site, I'll put all my images in a separate folder called images or IMG If that was the case, you'd have to type name of your folder, /, and then the name of the file. But like I say, as this little image is loose in our folder there, we can just put that in. Now all images should really have an alt tag. And the alt tag's just really a description. But you can also use it for putting in keywords for your particular site or geographical information to help your SEO a little bit. Okay, so I've tagged it as an image and I've said where the image is at. And with brackets, if you hover over it, if you've got the correct image, it'll just show you what image you've got there. And we've given it an alt tag. So let's save that, Control S, and go back to the site. Now when I refresh, our logo should appear here. It's going to make that navbar a lot wider. There we go. We've effectively put a logo in our navbar here. Okay, well let's get this organized. At the moment it's stretching the full width of the actual navbar itself. If you want to have it more inward or contained, we can just wrap it all in a container. To get rid of that search box, we don't really need that. Go back to our brackets. Here's the search box. It's a form. Don't want that there. Let's just move that. I did was hit delete. And got rid of the gaps there. Control S back to the site. Now when I refresh, that search box should be gone. Now again, this is a little too far over to the left hand side. I like to see it sort of about here. And there's two ways we can do that. We can either wrap our section in a container or we can just add some padding. Let's do the first one. Let's wrap our container in some padding. Don't want it right there because that's going to be the background. So I want it just underneath. So all I need to do is add new section or new div with the class of container. And that will put everything wrapped in this. It'll give it some automatic padding on the left and right. I'm going to cut that closing div and I'm going to put it right on the bottom here. And because I've cut that div, you see that's turned red. That's telling us we've got a problem. Something's not right. Now when I put it back in, it's gone to the correct blue color. Shift that across, just keep it all nicely lined up. Save, Control S, and let's go back to our site. Now when I refresh, our container should be around about here, and it will have gaps either side. There we go. Now that's one way of doing it. The other way is to just simply give this element a bit of padding on the left. So if we go back, let's just take that container away. You notice I put that container under the nav there. Got to get rid of its div on the bottom as well. And we can now take this back one. Save, that should now be back as it was. Refresh, there we are, it's back as it was. The other way to do this is simply give this some padding on the left hand side. So I'm using Google Chrome here. If you hit right click and hit inspect, there we go. It's got our nav bar and our image highlighted there. And all we have to do is give our image some padding. on the left hand side to push it towards the right. Let's say 150 pixels perhaps. There we go, and as you can see, that's pushed that over, and you can do as much or as little as you want there. Let's leave, what about 200, I think, probably. That'd be about right there. So you've now got that pushed over using that. And to actually make that permanent, we have to write some CSS. And if we look here, we've already got some inline CSS or on-page CSS here. So what we're trying to affect is this image element here. So it's navbar brand image. We can actually just do navbar brand, but let's actually target the image itself. So it's going to be, it's a class. So it's going to be dot navbar brand. And then we want to target the image. So we've targeted navbar brand class. Now we want to tell it we're targeting the image, img. And what did we say? We said padding left of 200 pixels, wasn't it? 200 pixels. Semicolon. Right, let's save that, Control S, and go back to the site. And that should actually stay exactly the same. There we go. We've now got our 200 pixels there. Now, for anybody that might be wondering, we may have to put a media query in when we reduce down to mobile size. Let's just do that. Let's hit the inspector. And hit our mobile button. Now see, when it breaks down there, we may want to adjust where our logo actually is. Because when we get on smaller devices, probably want that logo central. But that's up to you as well. You see we've got that padding on there. All I've done is right clicked and inspected on it. It's highlighted the one I want. And there's got our padding left. So we can put a media query saying when it's below a certain size, we can have padding 0. We'll put it all the way to the left. Or you can just say padding 100 or whatever to put it in the middle or wherever it is you actually would like to see your padding. Or I should say, we'd like to see your logo because you're not seeing the padding. But you can simply put in a media query to adjust it for mobile settings right there. Good. So there we have it. Okay, so we've put our logo in there. And you may think, well, great, logo's in there, fantastic. A little too big. I don't like this navbar being as wide as that. That logo wants to be smaller. Well, there's two things you can do. You can either go back and save your logo as a smaller sized image. I saved mine as 100 by 100. Or you can use a bit of CS to tell it what size you want. So again, I'm going to right click and inspect. Get rid of our mobile toggler there. And here's our navbar brand image, which is what we want to work on right here. And I'm going to say height. Say I only want it 50 pixels. Height, colon, 50 pixels. And it's automatically, it's brought that down in size to a sort of more manageable size, or whatever size you'd happen to want your logo. Like I say, you can always, or you can save the original image as a smaller size. Or you can use a bit of CSS like we're doing here. 75 looks good, or 70. Let's make that 75. I don't know why. Okay, so we've done that now. We're happy with it. Let's just copy that height, 75. and go back. And we don't need to put another title in because we've already got one there that's affecting this. We just need to put this underneath there. Control S to save, back to the site. Get rid of that inspector. And there we have it. It's got our 200 padding on the left, and it's got our 75 pixels height. And that's a great thing about Chrome Inspector. You can right click on element, expect it, write some CSS here. Well, let's just make that 175 now. Way too big. And it'll affect it so you can see how things are going to look. But once you refresh, it'll take it back to how it was. So it's non-destructive. Once you're happy with the CSS you've written, you can just simply copy it, paste it into your on-page or inline style sheet, or if you're using one, an external style sheet, cascading style sheet, and do it that way. So there you go. That's how to add your logo and customize your logo with Bootstrap 4. I hope that's been useful to you. If it has, please like and share the video. If you're interested in web development, take one of our courses below. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.